Now Melanie Sinclair on vault for Florida.
Yurchenko full. Beautiful, and she knows it. You gotta love that energy.
It's a 9.90. They're building for the future at Florida. It's gonna be too little too late in this championship. Back over to the beam we go. Tiffany Tolnay. What a day she's had in all of the events.
Punch front. At this point, Tim, they just need to hit their routines.
It's got to be a comfortable feeling knowing that if you just routinely go through what you're supposed to, you're going to win the national championship.
Well, when talking to some of their coaches, they trained this event with the attitude of, we need 6.99s or better. Putting the pressure on in practice helps them handle this pressure. Two back handsprings to a double tuck. Little step, but good enough.
Yeah, I mean, regardless, it's going to be a quality score. Maybe not a 9.9, but her teammates have certainly picked her up. That's a 9.750 for Tiffany Tolnay. When we come back, Georgia looks to lock up the national championship and add a little more hardware to their trophy case. Back here at Stegman Coliseum, a look at all the championships the Georgia Gym Dogs have won. Winning four in a row would be an amazing accomplishment for this team.
Our seniors have an opportunity to compete for four in a row, and on top of that, to do it right here at home.
The pressure that's there is really on the outside, people saying, you know, you've got to win four, you're going to win four. But for us, each year is a new team, and we really look at it like that, and this team has never won a championship before.
As you look at Suzanne Yocklin, you can see the anxiety. She knows her team could win another national championship if there are no major missteps along the way. Here's Grace Taylor on beam.
Beautiful leap series. And watch this, Tim. This is worth nothing. But I'll tell you what, the crowd appreciates it, and it shows off her flexibility.
She won the individual title on this apparatus.
Beautiful turn with the leg extended. Something that stands out about Grace is she has great dance and extension through her legs. Front aerial with that blind landing and not even a balance check.
To have been a freshman on the team that won in Salt Lake has to mean a lot. I mean, you're older than a sophomore in this situation if you happen to compete for Georgia.
Finishing it out with two back handsprings to a double full.
Another magnificent performance. Crowd wants a 10 for Grace Taylor. And mom and dad, Lynn and Daniel, with a nice celebratory kiss. And a 9.875 for their daughter. Now let's go over to the vault and Ashley Reed for the Florida Gators.
Performing the risky Yurchenko 1.5. And it paid off, I'll tell you what, huge vault.
Well, you've got to be impressed with the way they've come back in this competition. Ashley with a 9.950 and 49.40 for Florida on vault. Now the floor exercise, Tabitha Yim, the outstanding veteran star of the Stanford team.
We talked about her intensity. I love seeing her smile on this event, see a little bit of her personality.
Says a lot when you've got a conference that includes an all-around champion at UCLA like Schweikert that you are the gymnast of the year in the Pac-10, which Tabitha is.
Well, they had a phenomenal performance at the Pac-10 conference championship leading to this competition. Finishing her routine out with a round off 1.5 front full and a very nice landing. And she looks relieved.
Yeah. Stanford has really looked good in this national championship. And Tabitha's had a lot to do with it. A 9.90 for her. Well, Katie Heenan, a leader of this Georgia team on beam at a 9.95 in the prelims. This is her last routine as a gym dog. Means so much to her as well as this program.
All she needs to do, Tim, is hit this routine that will ensure 5 solid scores for the Gym Dogs, which will make their lead almost insurmountable. Beautiful flight series. As if she knows this is her last chance to be a star in front of this crowd.
Oh, yeah. No question. To think that you'd win a national championship in every year you competed. That's what's in front of her.
Finishing it out, round off, double full. Wow. Tim, I didn't think there was a single thing wrong, and it is not too often that I say a routine deserves a 10, and I'll tell you what. That's pretty close.
Look, if not for a 10, it still means probably a national championship. She may have just sewn it up. If the score is what we anticipate it being, this lead is probably not one that can be caught. 9.950. It would take a Herculean effort for anyone to catch the Gym Dogs.
And look at her excitement. She knows she clinched it, but more importantly, what a way to go out your senior year.
Meanwhile, Ashley Claire Kearney, who's been outstanding throughout her career, now on bars for LSU.
This was going on while Heenan was on the beam. She anchors for LSU on every bit. Because of that, she is dynamic, and she can get big scores.
LSU is still in the race for second, and we're at this stage of their program. What? How much would that mean?
Well, finishing it out right there. Beautiful dismount. What an incredible day Ashley has had.
Fantastic performance by Ashley Claire Kearney. She was concerned in the prelims about her efforts and whether they'd make it this far. They did, and she's come up big on bars, 9.904 and 49.20 as a team. Back to the beam, Courtney McCool with, I guess, the cherry on top.
That's right. Pressure is off. Get out there. Have a good time. Courtney's still very competitive, will do everything she can to post another huge score for the Gym Dogs. It's a very similar experience in Atlanta for our team because it is hometown crowd. When they're on the beam, it's pretty quiet. When they land, crowd goes wild.
Yeah, back in 96, you remember that, right?
That's right. Here it goes, the last landing of the day for the Gym Dogs. Round off, double full. And they did it again, and Suzanne knows it too.
There's her father, Mike McCool. And like the fans and the rest of this Georgia team, I think they know that this isn't a championship, it's more of a coronation. Look at that. Yet another 9.90 for Courtney McCool in Georgia. And the Gym Dogs now have put themselves in a position where truly they have built an insurmountable lead, one would think. Look at that score. After rotation 5, 197.450. And the race for second includes Utah, Stanford, and LSU when we return. Welcome back to Athens, Georgia. It does look a little bit like a curtain call or coronation for Georgia as they sit out here in the sixth rotation awaiting a national championship for the fourth straight time. Utah, Stanford, and LSU would need multiple tens in their final rotation to have a chance at catching the Gym Dogs. And Kristen Smith's team has really acquitted itself beautifully. And here in the final rotation, Stephanie Gentry, senior from Plano, Texas, will get things started.
Yurchenko full. Big step there on the landing. And you know, it's at this point, Stanford needs to be sticking every landing.
And her vault garners a 9.750. Utah's Jessica Duke from Sandy, Utah. Another senior, her final performance on bars.
Like Coach Marston said earlier, they've got to hit these handstands and stick their landings. Beautiful ginger. Moving right down to the low bar with a shoot to handstand.
Mathematically, Utah would need an average of 9.935 in this competition to catch Georgia.
That's pretty tough to do, but it will come down to the landings. And right there, that hop will take it from a 9.9 down to that 9.8 range.
That being said, though, this contingent has got to be proud. This could be the third straight year Utah finishes second in this competition. A 9.80 for Jessica Duke.